And now we'd like to welcome Dave from the Seneca Park Zoo to the show. Hey, Dave, I'd high-five you.
Hi, Dave.
But it looks like you got some.
Yeah, I don't think I want to do that.
So what do you got for us today?
Well, I have a giant African millipede, which comes to us from Western Africa. So in the tropical, subtropical areas of Western Africa.
All right.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Now, that's a lot of legs. Are they born with that many?
So, good question. And everybody usually asks us, do they have that many to start out? And no, they usually start with about 6 legs, as normal, you know, invertebrates would. He is going to grow. Each time he grows, he'll molt. And then he'll actually shed a section. And then another section will come out on the end. And then he'll get 4 more legs. So 4 legs per each section.
Yep.
Okay. So he'll just continue to grow and grow.
Why does this invertebrate need so many legs?
Well, the reason he needs so many legs is because he lives in an area where he has to be like a little tank. He will run through the bottom of a forest floor with lots of dead leaves and dead vegetation, and he has to find them and eat them as best he can.
Okay.
So that is kind of his move, and he is a decomposer, which is really, really beneficial for the environment. So he needs lots of legs to kind of go over and under a lot of decaying plant matter.
Cool.
Mm-hmm. I like how you said he runs through the forest floor, but he doesn't seem to be running. Is this as fast as he'll go?
Yes, and it is actually kind of slow for a millipede today. he is going to move about this speed. They don't move very, very fast, and that is because they don't really need to. And they're going to go nice and slow so that they can get from place to place, and that is pretty much their kind of, you know, that's how they do things as a millipede.
It's my kind of running, right?
Yep. So now the millipede has a front and a back, and on the front it has antenna. What are they going to use them for?
So the antenna, as you can see, is kind of tapping along my arm as he runs up me here, and that's because he is sensing, he is feeling, and he is hearing and tasting all from those antenna.
Cool.
I'm
going to
move him back down towards my hand here.
All right.
And those actually help him navigate his area, especially in an area where it's very, very dark most of the time. So he can see light and dark mostly. Other than that, those antenna kind of navigate him through everything.
All right.
Okay, I wanted to ask, go back to the whole how fast do they go piece.
Yes.
How do they defend themselves if they're that slow?
Well, very, very good question. So what he likes to do is he'll roll up into a ball, which
kinda like
starting
that.
To do now.
Yep.
As soon as I touch him, he rolls right up into a ball. And then what's interesting about that is he will then exude some really foul-smelling things from his rear area.
Yeah. Right.
And it's going to be called musking. And what he's going to do is a foul-smelling and tasting substance will come out. It actually has small amounts of cyanide in it.
Really?
So that's going to really deter a lot of animals and make them sick if they end up committing to eating a millipede.
Ew.
Now, with the antenna, this is an insect.
Yes.
And
Not all quite.
Insects have antennas?
So not all insects have antennas, and he's actually not quite an insect. So he's a proto-insect, meaning they derive from similar things, but they kind of split at one point. And proto-insects, he does not have 3 body parts like a normal insect would.
Right, head, abdomen, and thorax.
Yep, exactly. No, he actually starts with 3 segments, but they're not body parts. And what happens is he'll continue to grow, as you can see. He doesn't just have 6 legs like most insects do.
Mm-hmm.
He's a proto-insect, so he's an invertebrate, which we call.
Okay.
Which just means he doesn't have a backbone.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So then is what you keep touching there the shell? And if it's not, what is it?
So a lot of times we call things shells, armor, that kind of thing.
Nope.
This is an exoskeleton. So it's a good way for him to protect his insides because his skeleton is actually on the outside of his body. Unlike us humans, our skeleton's internal. His is on the outside. So inside of him is all goop at that point.
Right.
And this actually keeps his shape and is nice and strong. Not super strong, though. He can't take a fall or anything like that. He has to stay on the ground because it'll actually crack. And then that'll kind of compromise his health.
Okay.
If that happens.
So you were saying that how they motor underneath vegetation and stuff like that. So you won't really find these guys climbing up trees then?
No.
Even though they look like they could do that quite well.
Yes, no. They need to stay on the ground, which is mostly what they're doing. And that's where a lot of their food sources are. And that is most of the times where you'll find them on the ground. You go even in Rochester, roll over a log, you'll find some of his cousins that are local to the area. And that's just because that's where his food is. And a little bit what we can do to help out is to just recycle ourselves.
Sure.
These guys are the recyclers of the rainforest.
Yep.
And we like to kind of promote that practice as well. So keep recycling and doing all of our great practices we do at home.
Composting things.
And composting,
like that.
And then you'll promote millipedes and everything else.
Very cool.
Okay, that's really good. Thank you.
So I don't see any mites on here, but they do have mites
they
that live
do
on them?
From time to time. Yeah, they'll get mites that live on them.
They clean them.
Yep, they clean them. They actually get them through areas that will help clean the body, and then they actually get food off of the millipede. So it's symbiotic.
Right, very Very cool. Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, thank you very much, Dave.
Thanks a lot.
If you would like to learn more about the Seneca Park Zoo and see other videos about animals, visit our website, homeworkhotline.org. And now, stay right there. We'll be back in a second.